Good evening. In my previous lecture, I have discussed the forward interpolation and problems based on forward interpolation. Forward interpolation, I have told that forward interpolation are used when the when we have to find out the data in starting. If 1, 2, 3 are given, data number are 1, 2, 3, then if we have to find out 1.5, then we use the forward interpolation. And today we will discuss the backward interpolation. Backward interpolation is used when we have to find out the value in the end of the data. And how it works, I am telling you. In forward interpolation, we have written the polynomial ynx. Ynx is equal to a naught plus a1 x minus x naught plus a2 x minus x naught into x minus x1. And so on and so forth. Lastly, we will write down an. An x minus x naught x minus x1 and so on. At last, we will write down x minus x n minus 1. And in place of, instead of assuming y and x, this take this as 1. As in 1, we choose it in the form y and x. If we take this y and x is equal to a naught plus a1 x minus x n. We have if we choose a naught plus a1 x minus xn plus a2 x minus xn into x minus xn minus 1 xn minus 1 and so on a naught. Lastly, we an x minus x naught x minus xn x minus xn minus 1 and so on. And in the last, we will write down xn xn minus 1 xn minus x minus x1, x minus x naught, x minus x1, and so on. This is x minus xn, x minus xn, x minus xn minus 1, and xn minus 1, and lastly, we will write down x minus, last term will be x minus x1. This is your 2. We have in the forward interpolation, we have started from a naught, a1, x minus x naught, a2, x minus x naught, x minus x1 from 2 points, and last term an, x minus x naught, x minus x1, x minus x2 multiplication of terms up to the x minus xn minus 1. And if we reverse the process, that is we have started ynx is equal to a naught, a1, x minus xn, we have subtracted from the starting xn, a2, x minus xn minus 1, and so on, an, x minus xn minus 1, and so on, till x minus x1. And then impose the condition that y and y and x, impose the condition that y and x should agree at the tabulated points points xn, xn minus 1, xn minus 2 and so on, x1 comma, it passes through the point the points xn, yn, xn minus 1, yn minus 1 and so on, x1, y1 and x0, y0. If it passes through these points, then these points will satisfy hence we have putting x is equal to x1, we get x is equal to x1 in this, in place of x is equal to xn, x is equal to xn, x is equal to xn, xn. Then this term will be vanished, this term will be vanished, entire terms will be vanished. And we know that corresponding to xn, there is a value that is yn. Then here if we put x is equal to xn, then terms will be vanished and this will become a naught, here a naught and here is equal to yn. A naught, the value of a naught is equal to yn, the first value. Then we put x is equal to xn minus 1, xn minus 1, then this term will be vanished and this will be here. Then corresponding to x is equal to xn minus 1, there is a value yn minus 1 and yn minus 1 will become a naught, a naught plus here a1, and we have written in place of x, xn minus 1, this will be xn minus 1 minus xn, and the value of a naught is equal to y naught. We have calculated the value of a naught is equal to y naught, yn plus a1 minus xn, and we know that x1 minus x0 is equal to h, or xn minus 1 is equal to h in general. Xn minus 1 is equal to h, and if we reverse the process, then xn minus 1 minus xn is equal to minus h. In place of this, we will write down minus h, or an, and this will become, this is your yn minus 1 minus yn is equal to minus a1 h, and we have to find out the value of a1, then implies a1 is equal to yn minus 1 divided by h. We have cancelled this minus and taken minus sign from here, then yn minus 1 upon h. And yn minus 1, this is your delta yn, because this is the backward difference, therefore we have written the symbol for backward. The symbol for forward was delta in this case, and this is delta yn upon h. Then other values, yn minus 2 is equal to a naught plus a1 एक्स एन माइनस टू माइनस एक्स एन प्लस एक्स एन माइनस टू माइनस एक्स एन इंटू एक्स एन माइनस टू माइनस एक्स एन माइनस वन एंड दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस इज वाई एन प्लस दिस वैल्यू आई हैव रिटेन वाई एन माइनस वन डिवाइडेड बाई एच एंड द डिफरेंस इज माइनस टू एच प्लस ए टू हियर इज ए टू एंड दिस इज माइनस टू एच इंटू माइनस एच माइनस टू एच माइनस एच देन ए टू कम्स आउट टू बी वाई एन माइनस टू वाई एन माइनस वन प्लस वाई एन माइनस टू डिवाइडेड बाई टू एच स्क्वायर एंड दिस कैन बी रिटन एज डेल्टा स्क्वायर वाई एन अपॉन फैक्टोरियल टू एच स्क्वायर बाई कंटिन्यूइंग द कैलकुलेशन एंड वी जनरलाइज दिस वन हियर दिस इज ए टू द पावर ऑफ डेल्टा इज टू एंड वाई एन फैक्टोरियल टू एच स्क्वायर सिमिलरली इफ वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट ए थ्री देन ए थ्री विल बी इक्वल टू डेल्टा टू द पावर थ्री वाई एन डिवाइडेड बाई फैक्टोरियल थ्री एच टू द पावर थ्री सिमिलरली वी फाइंड आउट ए एन एन इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा टू द पावर एन वाई एन डिवाइडेड बाई फैक्टोरियल एन एच टू द पावर एन सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग दीज वैल्यूज इन वन Substituting these values in 1, we will get substituting these values in 2. Substituting these values in equation 2. Will get yx is equal to yn plus delta yn upon h x minus xn plus delta square yn upon factorial 2 h square x माइनस एक्स एन इंटू एक्स माइनस एक्स एन माइनस वन एंड सो वन द लास्ट टर्म विल बिकम डेल्टा टू द पावर एन अपॉन फैक्टोरियल एन एच टू द पावर एन एक्स माइनस एक्स एन एक्स एन माइनस वन एंड सो वन लास्टली वी विल राइट डाउन एक्स माइनस एक्स वन This is equation number 3. Let us first write 3 in the equivalent form. And this is your yx is equal to yn plus delta yn and this h will go inside then this will become x minus xn upon h and from here this is your delta square yn upon factorial 2 1 h in this bracket and another h in this bracket then x minus xn upon h into x minus xn minus 1 upon h and so on. The last become delta to the power n factorial n, and this is your x minus xn upon h, x minus xn minus 1 upon h, and so on so forth, lastly x minus x1 upon h. And putting p is equal to x minus xn upon h, or x is equal to xn plus ph. Then since xn minus 1 is equal to xn minus h, because we have started from the bottom, then xn means term before xn, that will be obtained by subtracting h from xn. Xn minus 1 is equal to xn minus h, and similarly xn minus 2 is equal to xn minus 2h, etc. We have h, and this can be written as x minus xn minus h, because we have written xn minus 1 is equal to xn minus h, and this is equal to x minus xn divided by h, x minus xn upon h minus minus plus h upon h, and this is nothing but this is your p, this will become p plus 1. Similarly x minus xn minus 2 upon h can be written as x minus xn minus 2h divided by h, then this can be written as x minus xn upon h minus and minus plus 2h upon h, and this is your p plus 2, and so on. Substituting these values in 3, we will get yx is equal to yn plus p delta yn plus p plus 1 upon factorial 2 delta square yn plus p plus 2 upon factorial 3 delta to the power 3 yn, and so on. At last we will write down p plus 1 p plus 2, and so on. This is the first term, there is no any p. This is second term, there is one p, second term one p, third term p plus 1, means the term is 3 and the number of factors is 1 less than the term, that is p plus 1. Similarly if we write down the nth number, then this will become p plus n minus 1, into delta to the power n upon factorial n y n. This is the formula for the backward interpolation. This is equation number 4. It is to be observed that this formula implies horizontal differences whereas the formula for forward interpolation implies the diagonal difference. Backward means backward interpolation consists backward interpolation because it contains value of the tabulated function from yn backward to the left and none of the right of yn, used mainly for interpolating the values of y near to the end of the set of the tabular values. And we write down a question based on this. The problem: the values of x in degrees and sine x are given in the following table. Here is x in degrees and here is the sine x. X is 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 and 40.